Hello dear students, today we will study the next lesson, lesson number 10, The Children Who Are Wanted Every Hour. And it is a poem. Poem means it is very motivational and inspirational poem to children. So every students must study and understand the meaning of the poem in full sense. Okay? The Children Who Are Wanted Every Hour. One day, Jawaharlal Nehru said that the children are the future hope of a nation. Children are the future hope of a nation. The nation's future depends upon the children. Now, the children are good. In future, the nation will be good. We will get good citizens, good people in future. So today's children are tomorrow's good citizens, tomorrow's future. So a country's future, a nation's future is absolutely or totally depends on the present children. So you will understand the meaning of this poem in full sense, and also realize your power, understand your power, and wake up from the your laziness mind. You should become more energetic and enthusiastic to serve the nations, because the nation, all the people of nation are expecting something from you. Okay, just listen. The children of spirit, children of will, children of muscle, brain and power, fitted to cope with anything, these are wanted every hour. Not the weak and winning tones, who are troubles magnified, nor the watch widow I can, but the nobler one I will ride. Do whatever you have to do, with a true and earnest see, bend your knees to the task, do it with an honest will. In the workshop, on the farm, at the desk, everywhere you be, from your future report children comes a nation's destiny. Listen the first chance. Totally four stanzas in this poem. One by one we will study. The children of spirit, children of will. Here the poet says that the children should have the spirit, enthusiasm, energetic mood. Spirit for motivations, spirit for doing every activities, spirit for doing your studies, learning your lessons. But children of spirit, the country wanted the children of spirit. Children of willpower. The poet says that the nation wants the children, those who have the strong willpower. Willpower, strong mind, the ability to take the decision in proper time. Children of will, totally courageous. The children of spirit, children of will, children of muscle. Muscle means physically strong. The country wanted the strong people, strong child, strong children. Children of muscle means physically strong. That means physically strong means without diseases, no disease. That means full healthy. Healthy students, healthy children. The country wanted the healthy children. Children of muscle, brain means wisdom, intelligent. The country wanted the intelligent boys, intelligent girls, and power, powerful mind. The country wanted the healthy children, intelligent children, and powerful children. Children of spirit, children of will, children of muscle, brain and power.
Here, how many points? Spirit, one point. Will, second point. The third point, muscle. Fourth point, brain. And fifth point, power. The boy just says that the five factors is necessary for a children. It's a basic for basic motivational factors. Every child has these five things, five factors. The one is a spirit. You should have the spirit, and you should have the willpower. You should have a good health. You should have a very good intelligence and very good powerful mind is necessary. Fit to cope with anything. And these type of children, they will not afraid anything. They will ready to fit to cope with it. That type of children will cope to anything. They have no fear in their mind. They will face any situations. They are every time, always, they are ready to do anything. Fit to cope with anything. These are wanted every hour. Every hour, the country wanted these five factors, these five types of children. Always ready to do the anything. The powerful children with a very good spirit, willpower, good health, good intelligence, good strong mind. These type of children, the country wanted these type of children. Fit to cope with anything. And these type of children, the country wanted every hour. The nation wanted every year. But these are wanted every hour. Once again, I will read it. The children of spirit, children of will, children of muscle, brain, and power, fit to cope with anything. These are wanted every hour. Once again, children of spirit, children of will, children of muscle, brain, and power, fit to cope with anything. These are wanted every hour. The children are full of spirit and willpower. That is the first line's explanation. The children should have a full spirit. The children should have a full willpower, a strong positive willpower, mental power. The second line, children of muscle, brain and power, they have sound mind. Physically strong means good health, that means sound mind and sound body. The children should have sound mind and sound body. They are fit to cope with any situation. They never wanted to sit idle. They are not ready to sit idle. Laziness. Avoid the laziness. They never wanted to sit idle. They always do the work. They are wanted everywhere. The country wanted these type of children. In that case, if a country has this type of children, definitely we can say that the children are the future hope of a nation. The nation wanted the children. The country's future is depends upon the children's hand. Next line, next stance. Not the weak can win in dawns, who are troubles magnified. Nor the watchword of my God, but the nobler one I will try. Not the weak and winning drones. Winning drones means complaining. Some students, some boys, some girls, they are always saying the complaints. They are saying the complaints against their friends, their parents, their teachers, their school. And this type of children are known as the winning drones. Drones means lazy people, lazy students. Actually, these type of children, they are the lazy people. Lazy means not energetic. But not the weak and winning drones who are troubles, who our troubles magnifies. If any silly problems, if any simple matters, they will magnify it. They will change the simple problem into big ones. Magnify means to enlarge. Even the simple problem, they will magnify it, they will enlarge it. Who are troubling magnified. Nor the watchword of I can, but the nobler one I will try. So the children should not say, I cannot do it.
You can't do it. If you have a spirit, if you have a willpower, if you have a sound mind, if you have a sound body, sound brain, willpower, you can definitely say that I can't do it. Don't say I can't. At the winning donation, the lazy students, the lazy children, they always say that I can't, I cannot do this thing. But you should not say this type of words. You should not use this type of words in your life. But the nobler one, I will try. But the spirit of children, the sound body children, they will say what? I will try. I can do it. So every child should use this word, say, I will try or I can do. One saying, now we go to the second stanza. Not the weak are winning crowns, whoever troubles magnified, nor the watch word of I can't, but the nobler one I will try. The third stanza. Do whatever you have to do with a true and earnest zeal. Bend your seams to the task. Do it with the honesty. Do whatever you have to do. If you decide to do anything, you should do the work. Don't postpone the work. Don't cancel your work. Don't avoid that work. Take that work and do that work. Do whatever you have to do with a true and earnest zeal. You should have the truth and earnest zeal. Zeal means energy. Z-E-A-L. Zeal means energy. With earnest, earnest means maximum, optimum, maximum energy, maximum truth. With honesty, you should complete your work. You should do the work. Whatever the work, you can do that work. With truth, with honesty, with earnest zeal, with earnest energy. Bend your strength to the task. Strength is power. Bend your power in front of your task. In front of your work. Take your work, take your task with power. You should give all your powers to complete your task, to complete your work. Don't it with an honest will. Do it with an honest will. Do all this work with very honest will. Will means the positive mind, shows the positive mind. Here the poet says, the poet used three words. The one is true, second is seen, and third one is will. The three factors is necessary. You should acquire the three factors. And these three factors will determine your success in your life. Truth, seen, and will. If you want to become a successful child in you, you should have these three qualities. You should keep the truth in your mind. See, energy, and will. Do whatever you have to do with a true and earnest zeal. Bend your knees to the task. Do it with an honest will. The last stanza. In the workshop, on the farm, at the desk, whatever you be, from your future reports, children, comes a nation's destiny. Maybe in the workshop, maybe you will in the farm, otherwise at the desk, table, bench, then whatever you are, from your future reports, children, then what you are doing now, that determines the future of the nations. That today's your work, that will determine the tomorrow's future of every nation. So now you may be in workshop, you may be in a farm, you may be in a, sitting in a bench or classroom, but only one thing, what you are doing, that is most important than where you are. You may be in farm, you may be in any other places, any part of the country. But what you are doing, that is most important than where you are sitting or where you are going. What you are doing, whatever you be, from your future reports, then what you are doing for today, What you are doing today, that determines the future of tomorrow's nations. But from your future report, children, comes a nation's destiny. A nation's destiny, a nation's future comes from where? The nation's destiny or nation's future comes from the today's work of the children. That now, if your work will be good, if your work are good, we can surely say that the future of our country became very strong. We will get a good future, our nations will get a good future. But only one condition, today's work should be well. So do the work in proper time, with truth, seal and will. And acquire these five qualities in your life. Once again I will, before winding up the class, once again I will say the five important qualities of the children. The first is spirit, second is will, third one is muscle, then brain and power. These are the five qualities must or should occur every child in our country. The third stance, if you go to the third stance, there we can see another three more factors. The one is the truth, see and will. And you also acquire these factors also, total 5 plus 3, total 8 factors. If you depend this 8 factors, or if you have this 8 factors, we can definitely say that the country's destiny, the country's future should be bright. So every student should understand the real meaning of the poem and act upon the meaning of this poem and change your attitude, change your visions, change your work. Okay, I wish best of luck to you. Thanks for watching this video. Bye.